Yeah. Okay, okay, okay.
I'm not an extremist or none of that stuff there. Everyone knows integration is something they've never wanted, yeah? Let's be so honest, that's the truth. No one, they don't want integration. Like, how am I gonna tell them about black history that I've got a white wife? It doesn't make no sense, like, don't tell them sex.
Would you oppose it to your kids?
Yes, I would.
What if your son brought home a white girl? Or an Asian girl? Or an Indian girl?
Lead by example. Wait, lead by example. Am I telling my child black history, this, that, boom, 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 and then it's like, oh. Yeah, but your mom's a white woman. In the future, everyone's gonna be like mixed race.
Your views or your parents?
No.
No, 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 no. Yeah. It's TB on the track again. Baby, tell me what you want from me. Let me see ya. Run the street like I'm Young Gotti. They really think that they can stop me, but they can't do me nothing. Baby, tell me what you want from me. Let me see ya. Run the street like I'm Young Gotti.
Today's topic is, do cultural differences affect a relationship? And would you have a relationship with someone from another culture?
Yes, yes. It does affect relationship because mainly down to families, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes some families are not very accepting of different cultures, so they can actually, you know, be quite harsh, and sometimes they're just abandoned. Like the person that's deciding to have the relationship.
Get disowned. Because, you know, some people don't realise it's not only about the relationship between you and that person.
Yeah,
that could be family. Your parents are from a different generation.
Hey.
So they don't get that. They don't get that whole blend of culture.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's not even the religion, it's the actual culture itself.
Yes.
People forget that. A lot of things, it's not about the religion itself, it's about the people's culture and what they're used to.
Their values.
So what, is everyone here saying then that they would go out with someone, they wouldn't go out with someone from another culture, another...
Do you know, when I was younger, I'll be honest, I was just like strictly dark skin girl, that's me.
Sweet Coco.
Like, that was me. I love to embrace my culture.
Yes.
But as I got older, I realised that sometimes when you love someone, you just love someone. Mm. It just happens, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I know it could be difficult in terms of like meeting the parents, etc., etc., but sometimes it could work, sometimes it can't. Just due to your experience and who you meet at the end of the day.
So
we're not saying that, listen, if you marry someone or get with someone who's the same culture as you, it can't not work. It's the same thing applied. It can never work and it might not work. So it doesn't matter about where it's from, it's the complications that comes with it. That's what it is. Like, me personally, if you're not black, you're not wife. Simple as that. No. it's kind of hard, and I'm very strict with it. I'm very, very.
Just remember. It's just color. Yeah, just color. You might connect with someone that is you.
Right.
You know what I mean? And when you love someone, you can't deny that, bro.
I understand.
You know what I mean? You can't deny that. But obviously, there might be complications.
That's a great thing now.
Because like I don't have black babies, yeah? I don't have black babies, nice black hair, dark skin. I don't have no curly head baby, no curly head, no mixed race. I just want to have a black chart. I'm very strict with it.
Yeah, but saying, just because you have a child with another black woman doesn't mean that you're going to get what you want. Genes are a complicated thing. You may end up you may end up with a coolie head, mixed race, blue eyed baby. It's possible.
It's not about the baby. Forget
about the gene style. It's more
so
about the
are you talking head. About what the, it could be? So you're saying, does it have to be Caribbean?
You could be, as long as your skin is black, you can be Caribbean, Africa, more.
So it's just, so for you, it's not a cultural thing, it's a colour thing.
So what about,
that's basically
about culture as well, because like this, imagine if I married someone Asian, yeah, and they're Islamic, yeah, and I'm a Christian, and we have children, and they all become Muslims and all that stuff. It doesn't make no sense. You gotta think like that, you gotta think kind of ahead. Eid, Christmas, all that. It doesn't make no sense, yeah?
Something that you will discuss, obviously. If you get together with the person, you're going to talk about that.
It's just not going to work, honestly. But even beforehand, would you even go for someone that of a different religion?
So for me, you have to be Christian. That's number one. I'm a Christian. You've got to be Christian.
You have to be full black.
That's it. After that, we can talk about other stuff, yeah?
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a very simple guy. Just two things.
I guarantee you, give it a few years, your mind's going to change.
No. You know why I'm not, yeah? You're watching this now, yeah? When I get married, I'll let everyone know, yeah?
Yeah.
You gotta be sweet, Coco. You gotta be a believer of the faith. Yeah, that's what's the two most important things for myself. Because if not, it gets very, very complicated. You know what I'm trying to say?
So what if she's not for example, a sweet Coco, but she's a Christian, wholehearted Christian, just as you are. She believes in God just like you, passion for God just like you, but she's not a sweet Coco 10 out of 10.
For real.
Sweet Coco just means black skin, that's what it means, yeah?
But she's not black.
I'm going to have to decline, unfortunately.
You ain't declining.
You know what it is, there?
You ain't declining.
It goes back to black history as well, yeah? I don't want to get deep into it too much, but it looks like I'm going to have to, yeah? It goes back to black history, yeah? The reality is this, yeah? I'm not an extremist or none of that stuff there, but I'm just, I try to keep my mind open to this stuff in it. So it's like, everyone knows integration is something they've never wanted, yeah? Let's be so honest, that's the truth. No one, they don't want integration. However, our ancestors like Martin Luther King and all these other people, Malcolm X, they fought for us and whatever, we've integrated. And I'm not against that. I'm happy that we can go to schools and work together and everything's mixed. However, don't forget, that's what I'm trying to say, don't forget, like, for me personally, I want to stay with a black woman, teach my children about black history, teach them everything about black culture, and I don't feel like I'm going to be able to do that properly. Like, how am I going to tell them about black history that I've got a white wife? It doesn't make no sense, like, do you know what I'm trying to say? It doesn't make no sense to me. Lead by example. Am I telling my child about black history, this, that, boom, 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 and then it's like, oh. Yeah, but your mum's a white woman. And I'm not against other race. I don't understand that I'm an extremist or racist. Sense. There's have to have a balance, that, you know what I'm trying to say? Because I would, my philosophy, I wouldn't oppose it to anyone else. I wouldn't say be like me. That's just how I am.
Would you oppose it to your kids?
Yes, I would.
Oh, wow.
My kids, yeah.
You would oppose it? My kids. They would have to be with a sweet Coco.
You can't force it, yeah? As
what,
you,
what, you, what if your son brought home a white girl? Or an Asian girl? Or an Indian girl? Mm.
He wouldn't do it, that's the thing.
But if he did, what would you tell him?
He wouldn't do it. And if he did, as long as he's happy, that's what's about like happiness. You can't control someone. As long as I know that I've given him the knowledge about black history, this, that, and that.
Are these your views or your parents'?
No, these are my views. This is my
So opinion. Your parents wouldn't mind if you came home with an Asian girl?
Oh, they wouldn't mind, they're Africans still. They were
there. To me, it kind of seems
no, no, it's not, parents' views are the same. It's not the same. It's not the same. Me and my parents.
I feel like it is.
It's not, it's different still. It's very, very different, man. My parents are more just. To just know African, they don't look outside. So like their region and my region are two different reasons. My reason is because of black history. Can you hear what I'm saying? I'm talking about black history and black cultures. Their reason is more of a...
Every culture has a history.
Yeah.
One, every culture has a history, but just because you are teaching and empowering your children or even other people about a particular culture, you're not putting down any other culture. Exactly. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So that kind of argument that you're making, it doesn't really make sense to me. Just because I teach my children about... my Greek heritage or my Italian heritage or my Chinese heritage or whatever it is, I'm not putting down anything else. I'm not saying that one is better than the other one. It's about learning about all different cultures and accepting all of them. Every culture has been through their struggles. Every culture has done wrong. Do you know what I mean? So I know my Italian side, we've done wrong in the past. Do you know what I mean? I need to accept that. And I need to learn about my history and teach my children about it. But it doesn't mean to say because I teach my children about their history that I'm dismissing every other history saying, or every other culture saying that ours is better because of X, Y, Z. And that, to me,
it kind
of
sounds like... No one's going to say that.
No,
but what
I'm saying is, if you're going to
put them in a box and be like, this is black history, go about that only.
I'm not saying that, but you're dismissing other cultures and saying that that's not for you and your children. You'll instill that same thing within your children. That to me sounds a little bit like you're saying this is better than everyone else. And not to say that you can't, if that's your views, but I just feel like it's
not really, darling. I don't feel you're understanding. That's what it is. It's not really, because all I'm saying is this, yeah? We're all equal at the end of the day. Like I said, integration, it's all about integration. Now, that's what's happening right now, so... For me to even tell my children that's going to be really difficult because everyone's, in the future, everyone's going to be like mixed race more or less in the Western world. Everyone's mixing, so that's going to be a challenge itself.
So you want pure blood?
There is no such thing as pure blood. When you think about it, right,
we all started,
even when you look at slavery, right, everyone moved around. So people, even when you look at, for example, when England decided to go and conquer the half the world, when they were to New Zealand. Do you know what I mean? There's so many different people who transferred from one country to another one, those who even moved over to Africa and had and raped the women there. Do you know what I mean? Over the years, I don't believe that there's any such thing as pure blood of one particular culture.
Mm-hmm.
We're talking about black music.
Yeah, but then your ancestors.
I'm talking about relationships.
I'm talking about relationships.
Black history is world history. If you figure it out, if you figure out where a lot of these different countries, Chinese, wherever they're from. They've stemmed from black culture.
I understand
genes.
That, but I'm not going to have a history of.
So I'm saying, even if you had a child of a different culture, you can stem their history all the way back to black history anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So you can just, and now we empower them even more.
I think you're just being lazy when it comes to teaching your kids.
Everything's black and white, bro.
Like, everything's black and white, bro. I think it would be even cooler if they know different languages, different culture, than just one.
Yeah,
I mean,
exactly.
Some of them can end up being bilingual now in 2 to 3 languages.
Mm-hmm.
And that's pretty cool.
But let's be real now, like what he's saying is it's not just his mentality.
No,
there's
a lot of
I mean, and I actually can see
and not just one race, is a lot of races with that type of mentality.
Yeah.
There is.
Like I got siblings there. Yeah? They can marry someone Asian. They can marry someone white. I ain't got a problem with it. It's nothing. I'm not against it. It's just my views. I'm trying to say, just me personally, I wouldn't want to marry someone
when
that
comes
along.
I think I'm open to any cultures, to be honest, but I would have not an issue, but I would feel away if the parents did feel away. But then I would hope my partner, who I'm with, would voice how he feels. Do you know what I mean? Because I think our parents and their generation, they need to understand that was then, and this is our generation now. We're trying to move forward, and I feel like they're kind of stuck there.
Stuck,
and which is respectable. So if I'm with my partner and someone saying Indian or something like that, and I will respect it, but they will need to know I'm here to stay, baby.
Yeah. Okay, so what if your partner was Indian and you're not just gonna change the whole race. Your partner was Indian and you guys were engaged, he was getting married, and he wanted to have a traditional wedding.
Ooh, yes.
And the family wanted the traditional wedding, but you wanted the big white wedding.
We're gonna have both.
Okay.
We're gonna have both. That's if I want to, but I'm very much for, I'm an open person. I like to learn about new cultures, new traditions and stuff, so I'm all for it. I'm all right getting in a sari and stuff like that. I'm all about embracing cultures and stuff. I'm very much traditional as well, but if that's what's gonna happen, cool.
It's not about all
we're gonna have sausage rolls as well. Do you know what I mean? We're gonna have it all. I'm talking about the suit, the white dress.
To me, that's boring. I feel like just in general,
that example there, even itself, it's not really in a complication of a cultural difference. It will be for the wedding day itself. I'm talking about like practices, like some cultures practice some things in it that you might not be comfortable with, or you might not want to do.
Some cultures are very similar. Like there's a lot, like Arabic culture and Italian culture are very similar in a lot of ways. Do you know what I mean? You never go to someone's house empty-handed. You go into someone's house and you offer to help out. Someone comes into your house, you feed them, whether they want to be fed or not. You feed them. Do you know what I mean? That's culturally what it is. In terms of traditions as well, they're very similar. There are a lot of cultures that are like, even Nigerian culture and Italian culture is very similar in a lot of ways. Do you know what I mean?
Not just religion, but that's it is a big factor. But even with the culture, Italian Nigerian culture have some similarities, but there's more clashes, there's more backlashes than similarities, and that's what the problem is.
Like what?
Just small,
I've been to Italy.
Relax your body. Just small stuff like greetings. So I'm trying to say, you're African, you greet someone, and you go prostrate. Some people be like, I'm not bound up for no one.
No,
am I wrong? Is that not a problem?
That's a big problem.
That's about learning other people's culture.
Yeah, but if you have a problem with that...
How many Italians have you ever told you that they have to bow and prostrate to?
I've never met Italian that I'm bringing up to my mum. That's why...
Very respectful.
They are very respectful. And the thing is, it's... You are going to find some people who are very closed-minded, and I'm not going to say that Italians generally are very open-minded, because a lot of them can be. But it's about
if you meet someone and this is the person you want to be with, in the same way that you make sacrifices and you change certain things to make your relationship work, in terms of, let's say, going out or whatever it is that you find works for you, you make that same effort to get to know your partner and their culture. And if you love them enough, even if it, let's say, it hurts your pride because you have to bow down to someone, if you do that once a month when you're going to greet the family, it's not a big rule. If that's what it's, if you feel it's worth it, if you have so much of a problem embracing someone else's culture, then maybe you need to actually reassess if that's the right person for you to be in a relationship with. If you're not willing to open up and see a different side of it.
Don't tell me, tell the guys that are on integration. Don't be telling me this stuff. Tell these men.
I want to go date someone. I mean, when you're starting to date someone, you're going to ask them what type of parents you have. Like, you're going to know if she's the kind of person that's going to want to invite you to meet their parents anyway. If she's not that kind of person, then you're not really going to see anything long term anyway. Like, it's just short term, we're having fun, then you move on. Personally, I don't care about cultures. If I know there's going to be a problem in the future, then I know for a fact she's not going to be my future anyway.
Well, but that's the parents,
No, it's not like there's a parents, but I just don't want that hassle. I can't, don't want
but
that.
If you love it's somebody, too much. How can you say it's not hassle. Nothing comes easy. Nothing comes easy. That's me a challenge.
No, it's not
like
that. It's not like that. If I meet somebody and I know, I'm going to be asking her a question, what do your parents think about a black guy and all this and that? If she's still going to tell me that, and that's a bit comfortable, my parents doesn't like that, then I don't see a future there anyway.
You're not letting her get up.
Who are you going out with, the girl or their parents? It doesn't matter. It's not that I wouldn't, you know, try to have that challenge. But for me, my mentality is like, that's just too much, though. I can't put
time. Gandalf, as a man, are you going to take what's yours?
Of course I'm going to take what's mine. But
exactly. So why are you going to allow someone...
I'm that kind of person.
If you see a future with that person, why are you going to allow someone to...
I'm that kind of person. There's many women out there.
Really?
There's no future with this one.
But how do you know...
There's future with another one.
How do you know it's not good, they're going to match the person that you care
because
about that
back then. I tend to gravitate towards people I like anyway, and people who like me. So
sometimes the grass ain't green on the other side. So you could have a great opportunity. When the opportunity is there, take it.
Well, that's what you believe in. Remember,
the grass is green where you water.
The grass ain't green on the other side. That's what all green is. Remember, we're talking about all these things to existence. For me, I think if this grass is always greener, every other side, and I believe in that, and I experience.
When the opportunity is there, take it. Simple.
What do we take it?
When the opportunity.
I don't understand what you're saying, Sylvester. What are you saying? So are you for it or are you against it? Are you for it, yeah?
In the sea. I'm not going to waste time on one that has parents.
Because their parents don't accept.
Yeah, I don't want that hassle.
I don't feel like the girl that much there. I don't feel like the... You don't like the girl that much.
I've cut my mum.
Yeah,
she was with my dad, who's Jamaican, and then she is now married to an Asian guy.
Yeah.
So trust me, I know about intercultural relationships.
Jeez.
And it's not easy. It's not everybody.
I can meet a girl here that has very strict friends and family, and I can meet another one that doesn't.
There's still something within that culture that you're gonna have to compromise with, as long as the parents are fine with me,
I don't care about anyone else. If the parents are not fine, then I'm not. That's just wilder to me.
Yeah, but have patience. Earn respect.
So what if the mum loves you, but the dad is like, I don't want a black man dating my daughter? Then what do you do?
Well, it's 50-50. Well, one likes me and one doesn't like me. So I'm going to try and prove to this guy that I'm a cool guy.
So why is it worth the risk because half the job's already done?
I already told you I'm lazy. I already told you.
told you I have a lazy mind. It's not that I wouldn't fight for it. It's just that I can't bother with that.
I think
No, guys, I think with those scenarios, you got to put yourself in the parents' shoes, because one day we're going to be parents, yeah? So when we have children, if you...
This is feminism.
You're right. So if you do have kids, yeah, and then they bring home someone that you're not happy with, or they're from another race, what would you do? So before you start answering that, you got to see it in that perspective. You got to put yourself in that shoes.
Let them gain that knowledge.
We're from a different generation.
Do what they want. There's a difference between not liking someone because of their character and who they are as a person, and not liking someone because of their culture. They're two completely different things. If you're bringing home someone that I can see is treating you badly, I'm not going to like them. I couldn't care less if they look like Barney. I couldn't care less whatever culture they're from. If you're not treating my child as they should be treated, don't come in my house. And it's the same thing that my mum has always said to me. Like, if the person makes you happy, I don't care if they're yellow, purple, orange, blue, red, if they're from whatever culture, so long as you are happy, do what you're doing. And even if she sees the person isn't the right person for me, she's gonna tell me, do you know what, I don't think this is the right person for you. But she's gonna let me live that and experience it myself. The only time she's ever said to me, I don't like this person, and that is because of them as a character, not because of where they're from. I don't think where they're from plays too much of an importance. Like, but I have to say my mum's quite an open-minded person. If I was to live with my grandma or maybe my uncle or auntie that live in Italy, it could be completely different. They're not as open-minded, do you know what I mean? So for me personally, if I have children, so long as they're happy and they're getting treated well, I'm good.
Religion as well, it does play a big part to it. It plays a really, really big part to it.
What if you found a sweet Coco Christian woman and then
she was Muslim?
You got into the relationship and she decided to change the faith.
Wow.
What would happen?
Yeah.
Well, every relationship you've got to compromise, innit?
Wow. Yeah. But who would make the compromise?
It'll be her, she'll coming back, innit? She'll be coming back. Hey, run that back, yeah? Come on. No, she'll be coming back. And if it doesn't work, then it's not meant to be. Simple as that. You know what I'm trying to say? That's how I see it as.
But now you've
you said relationship, you didn't say marriage, don't change the scenario.
These are scenarios that could happen. This is
Remember, you don't have a prenup.
He's got to be hopeful, innit, man? He's got to be hopeful. I feel that.
It's a big one for me as well, because obviously, Christian, yeah, and everything like that, but having, I don't know, I could go out with a Muslim. I just don't know if I'll have energy to pray five times a day. But, do you know what I mean? But,
not in brief, all of them play five times
I know, but I'm saying there's different cultures and stuff like that.
Because
but,
you don't even come, it's praying, it's food as well.
It's food, yeah. It's food, so, it's halal, being you know, uncomfortable to be comfortable. So, that's something I'm gonna have to learn. I will kind of go on the journey doing, and who knows, I could be. Leading lessons and you know doing praise and stuff, so it just takes time.
You have to change your name as well.
Yeah, it takes time, but for me to change my name, I should know what I'm going into as
Know what you're doing.
Know what you're doing.
Like when you do,
you can't be surprised at these things that I have to cover myself and stuff. Don't be surprised at these things. You knew what you was going into. You know that person has a specific religion, be open to it and know what you're getting into.
Why can't it be?
Just remember, the names Christianity, Islam, Muslim, blah, blah, these are just titles, and religions are just a man-made thing of a way of praising a god. You've just put a name on it. There wasn't Christianity when Jesus was alive, or when he died, they didn't call it, okay, we believe in Jesus, so let's call it Christianity. It was a new thing. So when that happened, we have to figure out, take away the titles. Take away the titles. There's no such thing as Chris Lim. Take away the titles. It's just
confusing though for your child. It's going to be very, very confusing.
Take the morals from.
It's not confusing.
There's so much integration going on in the Western world specifically. In 2060, 2070, they ain't going to be just black people. Everyone's going to be mixed race. Everyone's going to be mixed. There'll be no more black people. There'll be no more white people.
You know, it's all about upbringing as well, you know, because I'm mixed and both of sides of my family have been lenient.
Mm-hmm.
Like my Jamaican side is fine. There's a lot of mixes in there.
Mm-hmm.
Saving my Greek side, there's a lot of mix in there. So it's different. We're coming from two different
backgrounds. Yeah, and that's why I said as well, I will never pose my view on anyone because it's not extremist, but it kind of is, isn't it? But it's like a balance. But I will never pose on anyone else. So I'm trying to say. So that's what I'm saying. You lot are happy to do what you want to do. I'm not against and all that stuff. So I'm trying to say.
I definitely believe in this day and age, it can work. It can work. Like, and if you just find that person that you gel with and you see a future with, why not try it?
Make it happen, that's why.
Cultural differences has a big impact on relationships, as well as faith and beliefs and religions. Both of them all contribute a lot. So for that reason, I think personally it's best to stay in-house. Not to say that mixing and integration can't work, like there's so many mixed race people that are happy together, like it's not a problem. But me personally, I would never go for someone that's not sweet cocoa, as I said before. And people might say you're just an idiot for that, but let me be the idiot and that's cool, you know what I'm saying?
Whether a relationship can work is dependent on the people that are in that. If you're willing to set that aside and embrace your partner's culture, then yeah, it's not going to be a problem. It's just about how open-minded you are and how willing you are to make that effort to be a part of theirs and allow them to be a part of yours.
No, 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 no. Yeah. It's TB on the track again. Baby, tell me what you want from me. Let me see ya run the street like I'm young boy.